Hi guys, I am harvesting my first batch of Callaloo, aka Amaranth, aka Jamaican Callaloo. Today is Saturday evening, so tomorrow morning, Sunday morning, we gotta have some Callaloo.
The first thing I do is cut off all the seeds from the callaloo stalks and then wash them. When I say I cut the seeds off from the callaloo, these are what I cut off, and they have the tiny black seeds in them. The next thing I do is prepare all this seasoning, get them chopped up like the garlic, white onions, red onions, scotch bonnet pepper. Usually I use fresh tomatoes. Here I'm using preserved tomatoes from my last summer garden. Now it's on to cutting up the callaloo. What you want to do is make sure you bundle them nicely and tightly on your cutting board, then start cutting, being very careful not to cut your finger. No guys, the callaloo wasn't that tough. It was just a knife that was dull, so I had to change knives. Make sure you get a proper knife to cut your callaloo or amaranth. Yes guys, I am boiling green bananas to go with the callaloo. I have a video on the channel. I'll link it just to show you how I boil green bananas. Now I like to use my duchy to steam stuff like callaloo or even cabbage because it's heavyweight. And so I put it on the flame and pour some cooking oil in it. Let the oil get hot. And my oil of choice here is grapeseed oil. When the oil gets hot enough but not burning, I start adding my garlic and white onions and red onions and tomatoes. Now I know when the oil is hot enough just from my 40 plus years of cooking, but if you want to make sure your oil is hot enough, you can use the handle of the wooden spoon, put it in the oil, and you will see the reaction with the spoon. Then I'll go ahead and give all the seasonings a good stir just to combine them nicely. Now it's time to add the callaloo to the duchy. So I add half of the callaloo and give it a good stir to combine it nicely with the seasonings in the pot. I then carefully added the other half of the callaloo to the duchy along with some sea salt. Again, I stirred the contents in the pot just to make sure that everything is nicely combined. I added my allspice seasoning to the contents of the pot and again give it a good stir to make sure that everything is combined nicely. You will need to add a small amount of liquid to the pot. Here I added some tomato juice. I then cover the pot and leave it to steam for about 10 to 15 minutes. After which I check to see how it's doing. I realize that it is almost finished steaming. And so I added a little more tomato juice just to make sure the callaloo does not stick in the duchy. And then I added some extra virgin olive oil like I like to do with my veggies when they are almost done. To determine the doneness of the callaloo, I take a bit of the stalk, because it's the harder part of the callaloo, and mash it between two fingers. Usually we have codfish with callaloo, and so I am using the same saucepan that my son used to fry his ripe plantains. So I put it on the flame, poured some grapeseed oil in, allowed it to warm up, then I added my garlic, white onions, red onions, and tomatoes. After allowing the seasonings to sweat down a bit, I then added the codfish to the mixture, stir for a bit, then added my five spice freshly ground seasoning, and then stir.
In my family, on Sunday mornings especially, boiled bananas, boiled green bananas, saltfish, and callaloo with all the onions and scallions and tomatoes was a favorite breakfast dish. I hope you guys learned something, and I hope you will try it. Thank you so much for watching the videos. Thanks for subscribing and liking, sharing, and leave a comment below, because I like to see when you guys comment and respond to your comments. Furthermore, all that helped the channel to grow, and I appreciate it immensely. I appreciate you. If you have watched this video and you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit that subscription button. And remember to hit the notification bell button so you can be notified of new videos with tips and tricks for your home and garden, lessons from my design studio, and some of my Jamaican Canadian recipes. Thank you guys again so much. You do have a blessed week. I'll see you in the next video.